May 4th. We're headed out. It's 9:30. Just got a call from Dad. He's getting ready to do some firewood. And turns out there's one goblin out there. I didn't even plan on hunting this morning. Weather was pretty crappy and raining pretty good. Just didn't want to get out into it today. It's still kind of early in the season, but they've been over there gobbling or going through there. It seems like at least one or two turkeys a day. And he said there's one gobbling right now, so I'm going to swing over there. Got a couple hours left of hunting time for the day. Noon it closes, so we're going to try to lure that guy in if he's still around when we get there. Should be Dad's in about 15 minutes. Try to get him in and film a hunt and see what we can do. You know, wish us luck.
We got out here, boy, nice bright and early time of 10 o'clock. We got in the blind, and like I said, Dad had called us saying there was one goblin. Sure enough, we pulled right up to the property, and they were just, this guy was going nuts out in the neighbor's field. So I ran into the blind down our skidway here. We were like, we're going to call him over. And anyways, you know, it sounded like he was just staying there. I called for, you know, 15, 20 minutes and waited. Nothing. He just would gobble and just stay right there. So what I did was, these bugs are horrible. I'm at the bottom of the skidway is where my blind is. And so we got right up close, you know, 15, 20 yards from the property line where the stone fence is that separates the neighbor's field from our property. And I was like, I'm going to call them over to us. And anyways, there's a hole in the fence that they like to cross. A deer cross, turkeys cross. So that's where I set my camera up there to film. I had it turned on there. I didn't realize there's another hole that they like to cross in behind me. And I heard them gobble after I'd called a couple of times up there. And I was like, well, he's on top of me. I was like, where is he? Should we be jumping over the fence anytime? And I just thought about it for a second. And I was like, I better look behind me. I look behind me, and there he's standing right there, probably 35, 40 yards. And my camera, I couldn't move. He had me pegged. I turned and whirled, fired a shot, wounded him, and I ran at him, finished him off. But he, you know, he did call him in, and he's one of my best birds yet. Shot a few times now. My best beard was like 8.5 inches. About like 24, 25 pound bird. This one's probably going to be about 20 pounds. And he's got, I mean, I don't know if you can see it, but pushing a 10 inch beard here. It's at least 9.5 inches. Pretty happy about that. It's got some good spurs. Looks like a swamp rat. He fell in the water, white died. A little puddle there. Flapped all over the place. Here's the spurs. Pretty happy with this bird. Yeah, nice big old gobbler. I figure it's at least 3 years old. And yeah, nice ratty tail feathers there, but pretty happy. Had a good turkey season now. Shot this beauty, and now it's time to get some work done and get prepped up and ready for the upcoming deer season. Feel free to subscribe or, you know, watch my videos. I've got a few right now. I plan on putting a few on each year, just share some stories.
All my sins are forgiven. no stranger to the prison. I've worn shackles and chains, but I've been freed and forgiven, and I'm not going back. I'll never be the same. I say, oh, my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. Oh, my sins are forgiven.